Well, last week's simulation was a little bit off, but let's see if this week's is any better as Louisiana Tech takes on the Roadrunners of UTSA. UTSA gets the ball first, and let's see what quarterback Frank Harris can do. Apparently, he can put the ball on the ground, but the offense recovers. Then on 3rd and 20, Harris puts up a prayer, and Cedric Woods almost pulls down the interception. So much for the arm punt. Tech takes over, and Luke Anthony is quickly sacked like we've never seen that before. And after the punt, Harris starts to show off his running ability with two big pickups. Then he throws a frozen rope to Ogle Kellogg for the first points of the game. Nothing doing for Tech's offense, but the Bulldog defense makes a huge stop to force a 4th and 1. The Roadrunners elect to go for it and run an option play that Tech defends beautifully. I'm starting to really like it when other teams go for it on 4th down. Let's check back in with the offense, where CJ Powell is able to break free of multiple defenders before the ball breaks free of him. Luckily, a teammate falls on it. But on 3rd and 6, Luke Anthony throws a dangerous pass that fortunately falls incomplete. On UTSA's next drive, Broderick Calhoun forces a fumble with a huge hit, and on the 3rd total fumble of the game, a defense finally falls on the loose ball. But Luke Anthony gives the ball right back. How nice of him. After the UTSA drive goes nowhere, Tech starts driving backwards after yet another sack. Avoiding the pressure this time, Anthony tucks the ball, trucks a linebacker, then turns over the ball. With time winding down in the half, the Bulldog defense hopes to keep the Roadrunners out of the end zone, but some poor pursuit angles result in 6 points for UTSA. Last week in real life, Tech's first good drive came at the end of the 2nd quarter. Will that happen here? Especially after Hardy hopes to provide a spark after this huge catch. But on 3rd down, the pass is way short of the sticks, and Tech has to kick the field goal to end the half. Starting with the ball in the 3rd quarter, the Bulldogs face a 3rd and 1, where pressure forces a bad throw. So with the ball at the UTSA 42-yard line, Skip is definitely going to punt the ball here, right? No, actually. Tech rolls the dice and picks up the 1st down. But after some weird video game bugginess, Tech faces another 3rd and short. The Bulldogs elect to run the option, which, doesn't go well. And Barnes trots out there for yet another field goal. UTSA goes 3 and out, and on Tech's next drive, Luke finds a wide-open Griffin Hebert, who just can't pull down the catch. Tech punts on 4th down, and on the return, UTSA is penalized for clipping. It's a 15-yard penalty, but Skip chooses to decline it. We're really nice like that. I guess it doesn't really matter, because on 3rd down, Deshaun Hall picks up most of that 15 yardage back with a sack. And Tech threatens on their next drive before Luke Anthony does his best Anthony Thomas impression and bruises down the field for a 1st down. The Bulldogs can tie it with a touchdown and a 2-pointer, but on 3rd down, the ball sails past Wayne Toussaint, and Tech kicks their 3rd field goal of the day. Just on the edge of field goal range, up by 8, UTSA elects to go for it on 4th and 1, and BJ Daniels gets stuffed. Tech now has just under 2 minutes in all 3 timeouts to drive down the field and win the game with a touchdown. The Bulldogs start building momentum after Hebert is yet again able to put a foot down, this time on a corner sideline route. Only 42 more yards to go, plenty of time on the clock, and still all 3 timeouts. A couple plays later, Tech faces a 3rd down, but they pick it up. Can the Bulldogs pull off these late-game heroics? Well, sacks don't help, especially when they're not even really the tackle variety, but the run-into-a-guy-and-fall-down type. Luke finds the fullback in the flat on the next play to pick up that yardage and more to bring up a 3rd down and manageable. But on that 3rd down, the game almost ends right there after the ball goes in and out of the hands of the UTSA defender. 4th down, here we go. On 4th and 7, Luke throws the ball into the back of the end zone, and it's too high for anyone. Tech turns the ball over on downs. And after a couple kneels, UTSA beats Tech for the first time since 2013. The Bulldogs fail to score a touchdown all game, and the Roadrunners are just able to put up enough points to be victorious.